Brother Ferdy and Brother Job, a hard task again. They're going to follow what I'm going to say this afternoon. In Joshua chapter 2, verse 1 to 11, I would like to read these wonderful verses unto you. Let's start from 1 to 11 of Joshua chapter 2. Then Joshua, son of Nun, secretly sent two spies from Sittim. And he said, Go look over the land, he said, especially Jericho. So they went and entered to the house of a prostitute named Rahab and stayed there. The king of Jericho was told, look, some of the Israelites have come here tonight to spice out the land. So the king of Jericho sent this message to Rahab, bring out the men who came to you and entered your house, because they have come to spy out the whole land. But the woman had taken the two men and hidden them. She said, yes, the men came to me, but I didn't know where they had come from. At dusk, when it was time to close the city gate, they left. I don't know which way they went. Go after them quickly, you may catch up with them. In verse 6, but she had taken them up to the roof and hidden them under the stalks of the flax she had laid out on the roof. So nagtinago itong si Rahab. So the men set out in pursuit of the spies on the road that leads to the ports of the Jordan, and as soon as the pursuers had gone out, the gate was shut. Before the spies lay down for the night, Rahab went up on the roof, doon sa pinagtaguan niya. And she said to them, I know that the Lord has given you this land, and that a great land and a great fear of you has fallen on us, so that all of who live in this country are melting in fear because of you. In verse 10, we have heard how the Lord dried up the water of the Red Sea for you when you came out of Egypt, and what you did to Sihon and Og, the two kings of the Amorites and east of the Jordan, whom you completely destroyed. In verse 11, when we heard of it, our heart is melted in fear, and everyone's courage failed because of you, for the Lord your God is God in heaven above and God on the earth below. The message we have this afternoon is we called making a decision that can impact your life. Amen? So again, making a decision that can impact your life. Whether we admit it or not, there's a lot of decisions in one's life that maybe recently you have done one, and then it impacted your life in one way or another, whether for good or for worse. Can you relate? Minsan may ginawa ka sa buhay mo that you make a decision, and then at the end of your decision, you regretted making that decision. Amen po ba? Sino yung mga gumagawa ng decision dito? You know what? This message is so important, it's so relevant for a couple of reasons. Why? Because every day you are confronted to make a decision. Amen? You're here today. Why? Maybe this morning, maybe yesterday, you make a decision, I'm gonna go to the church tomorrow. I'm gonna go to the Passion Church tomorrow because someone has invited me. Amen? Or maybe your wife dragged you down to Passion Church, or maybe your friend has invited you to Passion Church. And you make a decision. And the truth of the matter, whether you're Christians or not, whether you're religious people or not, you are confronted by every decision that you are about to make every day, every single day. If you will not be wise enough how to make a decision that can impact your life, I'm telling you this, you will suffer the biggest consequences if you will not be careful enough to make a decision. Amen po ba? Are you feeling excited about the message? If you think the message is so irrelevant, I'm telling you this, you better watch out. You better listen and keep your ears listening to the message that God has prepared for you this morning. Making a decision is very important and crucial moment in everyone's life, because in every decision we make, it will give us consequences. Happy mga possible consequences. Either it builds us up or ruin us down. It's either Let us move forward or let us stay where we are right now. Alam mo yung decision mong ginagawa is either mag-move you forward or just keep you stay where you are right now. And the biggest decision you could ever make is you try to equate and calculate the risk of making a great and courageous decisions in your one's life. Amen? The decisions we make has either short, take note of this, has either a short or lasting effect in our lives or in the life of others. Amen? May decision, ang effect, short-acting. But there's a decision in one's life that the decision is long-acting. You will not reap the consequences maybe in the next few days, but in the next month, in the next year, you will reap the consequences of the decision you have made. Amen? Amen po ba?
Amen.
Well, for example, if you have a wife, and if you have a husband, and then you have the sexual union because your husband and wife, and you make a decision, okay, let's make love. Hindi mo i-reap yung consequences no in the next few days. How many months?
Nine.
Kung normal. If it is premature, it's 8 months, 7 months, or 6 months. Amen po ba? But I would like to give you this wonderful warning of God for you. There are a decision you're going to make. You will reap them straight away. Amen? But whether you like it or not, whether it's you're going to have them in the next few days or maybe in the next few months, one thing for sure, every decision you're going to make, there is and there will always be a consequence. Are you with me? Amen? Another one. The importance of decision making must be learned by everyone today in this church. Because every day, as I said, we are being confronted by the need for a wisdom from God to make an important, not only important, but a right decision before God. Amen? I would like you to give a synopsis or the summary of the story that you've heard this afternoon. During those times, the Israelites people have sent two spies. Amen? Ano ba yung spies sa Tagalog?
Espia.
Okay. And then they have sent the spy, these two spies, into the household of Rahab. And si Rahab, for the knowledge of everyone, Rahab is a prostitute. Amen? It's prostitute. Tapos sabi niya rito, so the king of Jericho sent this message to Rahab, bring out the man who come to you and enter your house. Amen? Sabi niya, I know there are two spies who's now being coddled and hiding inside your house. But the most important decision in the life of Rahab is this. She made a decision that will change the course of the history, the whole Israelites people. And I will tell you later in the next few minutes. Bakit nag-change? Just because of this one important decision of Rahab, a prostitute. Mga kapatid, during those times, the prostitute is one of the lowest form and kind of, can you say profession? In other countries, we call it profession. I think in the Philippines, they also call it profession. If there is one of the lowest in the society during those times, that is the one who are working in the prostitution. Amen? Okay, babae ka, kalalaki ka, if you work as a prostitute, you are in the lowest, as they call it, the lowest of the lowest. But you know what? There's one thing that really inspired me. One thing, one principle that I have learned. And I would like you to start with this one. No matter whoever you are, the decision you are about to make will affect those who are so important to us or even to a very important people. Don't look at yourself na sabi mo, well, this is just me. And my decision doesn't matter a lot. My decision has no consequences. My decision has no effect. I'm telling you this. Always remember during those times, the lives, not only of the two spies, but the lives of the whole Israelite people. You know what? is now dependent on the decision that this prostitute is going to make. Isusumbong ko ba o hindi? Am I going to squeal? Amen? To the king that I'm keeping, I'm cutting the two spies. Mga kapatid, there are a lot of times you have to make a decision. Gagawin ko ba ito o hindi? Just like Rahab. Pero always remember this, if you're going to make a decision, tatanungin mo ang sarili mo, may consequences ba? Ang laging sagot, yes, there is. There is always a consequence. But during this time, Rahab, one of the admirable things about Rahab, she made a decision that changed the course of the history of the whole Israelite nation. Tinatago mo. You're keeping the spies. Sabi nga, well, a while ago, they were here. But I don't know where did they come from and where they have gone. Maybe they are now outside. Come on. Sabi nga, pursue them. Maybe you can still help them. Amen? During the time, it's not advisable at any case of all. But there's one thing that Rahab has said. Alam mo kung ano yung ginawa ni Rahab? He started to side with God. He started to be on the side of the living God in her life. Mga kapatid, the most important thing that a person can do right now, right here, at this very moment, is you have to start thinking on which side am I on? On which side am I in? Amen? Sa seminar, yesterday in the conference, when Pastor Rachel has flashed one of the slides, I was smiling in my spirit. Amen? You know why? Because in one of the slides it says, when the Spirit speaks, it must be coming from three sources. When you've heard three voices, it's coming from three sources only. Are you excited? In 3S. Number one, the voices must be coming from number one S, Satan. The devil, the enemy, the serpent. The old serpent. Amen? Mga kapatid, every time you make a decision, always ask this wonderful question. If I'm going to make a decision, who will be honored? Who will be exalted? Amen? Most of the time, you're not aware. Pag ba hindi ako nasimba, sino ma-exalt? Pag ba hindi ako nagbasa ng Bible, if I'm going to read my Bible, who will be exalted? Amen? If I'm going to tell a lie, if I'm going to be infidel, dishonest to my wife, to my husband, who will be exalted? Always ask the most wonderful question. Who am I siding with? Who will be honored if I'm going to make this decision? Number one,